Pohaku keli ahonui o ka lana ana oli o Kuhio Stone. I'm from the island of Oahu in the ahupua'a of Kahalu. So that's where I come from. And you know, people always ask me about, you know, why they'll make, you know, traditional surfboards out of wood and stuff like that. You know, it's what I was taught from a very young age. In fact, my first surfboard was made by my father. And the only way he knew how to make a surfboard was out of wood. I was lucky that I happened to be there watching him make it and then having the opportunity today to continue to do that. So sharing that knowledge of traditions here at the museum, I think it's a great opportunity for people who don't really understand the history and tradition of surfing to be able to experience it. So that's what we're doing. There's so much that connects who we are as people, our culture, our traditions, our practices, to that surfboard, for example. And then it connects us to our ʻAina and our kai, or moana, our ocean. But, you know, if we don't share it with people, people just don't know, and they keep talking about us as a native, but from their perspective or point of view. And so it just gets lost over time. It's usually a lot of fun because it's not only about making the boards and stuff, it's about connecting with people, right? And that connection is all about, it's how we share, right? How we share the knowledge, how we share the traditions. It's about how we share who we are. And it all comes through the, you know, that whole concept of sharing aloha. This word that everybody uses today and always is saying aloha, not really understanding what it means. So when I connect with people here, it's showing my spirit, it's sharing my spirit, it's the willingness to give my spirit to everybody else to make them feel, you know, that they belong in my space.
My name is Byron Kay, and I scuba dive, free dive, snorkel, adventure, and basically just make it possible for others to do that for a living. I like to enable people to get outdoors and experience the outdoors here in Hawaii because it is such a wonderful, special, magical place that I call my home. So we have people that come to Hawaii and they maybe don't have an idea of what we have here, but we try to educate them and show them some of the highlights. They can include swimming with dolphins, they can include swimming with pilot whales and other cetaceans. So I learned to swim in a way such that I was able to take a breath of air as a baby and then swim underwater and then take another breath of air, swim underwater to sustain myself. And ever since I was young, since I was one or however old I was when I learned, I've just enjoyed doing that exact thing, swimming underwater. I'm just not really much of an above water swimmer for some reason. I do enjoy it, but I really like to be underwater. It's kind of my happy place. So that really drove me into the sport of free diving, just that sensation, that feeling being underwater for as long as I can stay down there on one breath. I started really getting seriously into what I call extreme snorkeling when I lived on the island of Catalina in California. And I would go in the water every day from the Marine Institute there. And I would get in the water and swim around and see all the really cool marine life. And I guess at that point, I would consider myself an extreme snorkeler. And I really enjoyed it so much so that when I came to Hawaii, I went to two-step. And two-step is probably the best place in the United States and possibly the world to freedive. It's a very special place. And the freedivers go there every week. So yeah, one day I was taking some friends scuba diving and we got out of the water and put our gear away and I got out of the car and lo and behold, there's this beautiful, gorgeous woman standing there with a slick, smooth skin wetsuit. And I said to myself, I want to do that. And by that I meant freediving. I got some long blade fins and I plan to go to Honaunau on Sunday to meet the group. And the night before we had a poker night with the boys. There was definitely some alcohol involved. And the next morning I was a bit hungover. And so I stopped by the gas station, picked up a large coffee, made my way down to two-step. And after I got introduced to the freedivers, we went on the lines and I pulled down and held my breath. And it was pretty easy for me to hold my breath from the get-go. I think it was the first time or the second time I held my breath, I came up and apparently I blacked out. And I didn't even know it. But I had to be given like a breath on the mouth to come back. And the woman who gave me the breath on the mouth ended up being my wife, Jessica. She was a competitive freediver at the time. And we met and we got married and we have two lovely little boys who also love the water.
My name is Magdalena Carey. I live on Maui 15 years and I've been working for Hawaii Wildlife Fund almost 6 years. And what we do here, we have a lot of turtles that come here and bask in afternoon and nighttime. So we have a team that come every day, call us to be here to protect the turtles and also to educate people. So like you see, most of the turtles here that come every day, I'm very passionate for that because I love nature, I love ocean. I like to spend my time on the ocean. I like to talk to people. And this place is very special because like I say, so much people that come every day here because of the surf. And now they find out it's turtles here. So we're just here to educate and educate about what's the respect, what you have to do with turtles. It is a busy beach, public beach. So you see people crossing. So for us, it's very challenging because we're here all day and we make sure that people have the respect while we give them the education. And it's not just visitors, you know? It's also resident people don't have respect. So that's why we're here, to make sure everybody have that respect. I grew up in the nature, I grew up in the ocean. The ocean is like a park for us, it's a playground. That's what we have. And to know Hawaii Wildlife Fund, all this experience, be working with them, it teach me a lot how to connect to the ocean and be with the turtles. Is like, it's make you more appreciative of life and seem more aware. So most of the turtle here, all the green sea turtle, have a disease, it's a virus that grow on the soft tissue. What we do, we keep on ice of them to make sure, because resting, it helps them to reduce the disease. Hawaii Wildlife Fund used to send them to Oahu to treat those turtles. They were they remove the growth and then grow again. So what we love to do, at least, you know, is to help those turtles, the one have those disease, to decrease. It's very humid fault. So if we don't take care of the land, the ocean can be infected too. So yeah, just hoping one day all humans can be aware and then help those turtles. Not just the turtles. We have whales, we have monk seal, seabird, that truck with big net, entangled with rope, plastic, birdseed eating. So yeah, we just need to do the action and spread the word.
My name is Iokepa Naeole. I am a Maui native, and I currently run Halehuakai, our ocean activities department here at Kanapali Beach Hotel. We provide a service to our guests and non-guests. We take our guests out into the ocean and we show them what it's like to experience or interact with our marine environment through the eyes of the Native Hawaiians. And doing so responsibly and with reverence, and not so much with the mentality that you're in Disneyland and expect everything to happen for you, but you know, we like our guests to go out with us and see everything through our eyes and everything. So looking at the future for us, you know, we recognize here, even us working in the industry, that you know the amount of visitors that we get to Hawaii, They are affecting the quality of life for not just the local human communities, but the natural community too. So us being Hawaii's most Hawaiian hotel, we take it as part of our kuleana, our responsibility to you know, refine this practice of ho'okipa, or this hospitality, to the point where the guests that we draw are the ones that want to go into the ocean with us, or they want to, you know, go on a hike with us to experience what Hawaii is from the ground up. I would say my little shack here and our hotel, we're the leading edge, I think, of this revolution in the visitor industry and taking things back to the original concept of ho'okipa, hospitality, and practicing that as a culture, not just a business. The canoe, I mean, you find them all over the Pacific. This one happens to be state-of-the-art Hawaiian outrigger racing canoe. But for me, it's more than just something that I could take and race across the channel with five other athletes. It's, you know, to me, I can put five guests in here who've never been on the ocean, and it's like them stepping into a time machine and going back through history with me and showing them how my kupuna, my ancestors, used to go back and forth across islands. To put guests in here and show them the art of paddling and the concept of hoi va'a or paddling a canoe, it's more than just the paddle itself. It's about teaching them the values that helped us migrate here, settle here, and then create the dynamic culture that we become. You know, all those values that we teach during that 2-hour trip, I think, is more important than the trip itself.